Hello, this is Eric D. Kirk for MamaWorld.com, and welcome to the second part of this tutorial series where I want to help Premiere Pro users do their first steps in Adobe After Effects. Today we are going to create the following lower third, and I will show you the entire process from start to finish, even including the sound effects. We start in Premiere Pro by right-clicking on our footage and replacing the clips with an After Effects composition. In After Effects, we use the text tool to create our text layers. First, we create the text Okavango Delta, choose an orange color, the font Gotham Bold, and font size of 106 pixels. Then we create a second text, Botswana Africa, with a white color, the font Gotham Light, and a font size of 70. As a third design element, we now create a simple square shape with the rectangle tool. Before we create the rectangle, we need to make sure that no layer is selected, because if we had a layer selected, the rectangle tool would create a mask on this layer to crop it. However, if no layer is selected, the rectangle tool creates a shape layer instead. We click and drag in the viewer to create the rectangle. If you hold the Shift key pressed while doing this, the rectangle snaps to a perfect square. If you want to change or animate the size of the rectangle later, in the contents of the new shape layer you find here the size properties of the rectangle. Let's set it to 50. You also have properties to control the stroke and fill of the rectangle, but if the shape layer is selected, you can adjust this more conveniently here in the toolbar at the top. To place our layers accurately, we enable the Title Action Save guide here at the bottom of the viewer. Now I zoom in by simply moving my mouse wheel. Alternatively, like in Premiere, you can also choose a zoom level here in this drop-down below the viewer. If you keep the space bar pressed, the cursor turns into this hand tool that allows me to move around to see exactly the area I want. Now let's place the rectangle exactly here in the corner of our guides, and then place the Botswana text next to it and the Okavango Delta text above it. Here is a little design tip. Usually it looks very good if the distances and sizes of all elements in your design are based on common measurements. So the distance between the rectangle and the text should be something like exactly half the size of the rectangle, or exactly a third of it. To do this, let's create a little helper rectangle. We select the rectangle layer and choose Edit, Duplicate, or the keyboard shortcut Command or Control D. Now, in the duplicate, we go to the size of the rectangle path and set it to 25. That's exactly half the size of the other rectangle. The idea is that we use this rectangle as a ruler, so we can place the other text exactly so that this helper rectangle fits in the space between the text and the original rectangle. Now, the distance between the text and the rectangle is exactly half of the height of the box. If we duplicate the helper rectangle two more times, you can see that I actually have chosen the font size of the main text, so it's exactly three rectangles high. In other words, all sizes and distances in the design are multiples of a common base size. As a result, the layout looks very pleasing and balanced. If you find it a bit tedious to work with those helper rectangles, just check out our extension Grid Guide for After Effects, which can automate these kinds of layout tasks. Now we delete the helper rectangles and start animating. We reveal the position of both text layers, which you find here in the Transform section. To save a little bit of space, you can also select the layers and use the keyboard shortcut P, which will only reveal the position and hide all other transform properties. The same also works for R for rotation, S for scale, and T for transparency or opacity. Now let's move the current time indicator to the time where the text would reach its final position, say here, at about 1 second. Then we click the stopwatch to create a keyframe on both texts. Now we move to where the animation should start and drag the Okavango Delta text to the left and the Botswana text to the right. If you hold the Shift key pressed while doing this, the movement is limited to a single direction so that it is moving to the side accurately and not moving a few pixels up or down. Now let's improve this animation with what is called matte layers. Matte layers can clip the visibility of a layer, similar to masks, but while masks are moving with a layer when it is animated, mattes live on their own layer, and hence do not move with it. You can use any layer as a matte layer. Usually you want to use shape layers. So let's use the rectangle tool, and again, make sure that no layer is selected because this would create a mask on that selected layer instead of creating a shape layer. We draw a rectangle around the Okavango Delta text, move the layer directly above the Okavango Delta text layer, and in the text layer choose as Track Matte Alpha Matte. If you cannot see the track mat drop-down in your user interface, you can toggle its visibility with this icon here in the bottom left corner. As you can see, the shape layer has now become invisible, and that's because when setting it as a track mat, After Effects disables its visibility with the eyeball icon here. If you select the layer, you can still see its bounding box. If we now move the playhead, you can see that the text disappears at the boundaries of the mat layer. If we move the mat layer, the visibility of the text changes accordingly. So let's position the mat so that the text appears exactly like this guideline here. Now for the second text, we also create a mat layer. Let me show you a second variant here and draw a shape layer around the area where the text should not be visible. Again, we move it directly above the text layer, but this time, as track mat type, we choose alpha inverted mat instead of alpha. As you can see, now the text is not visible in the area covered by the mat layer. Now this animation looks okay, but still a bit boring and mechanical. You could spend a lot of time now tweaking the timing and ease of the animation with different keyframe types, but instead, I want to use our extension Squash and Stretch Pro for this. So let's delete the keyframes of our animation again and use some behavior from the broadcast bundle instead. This bundle has an entire section called Mat Moves, which contains behaviors that have been designed exactly for this purpose, to let layers appear or disappear behind mat layers. They all look similar but vary in their speed, easing, and how they deform the layer. Let's use the Appear Thrown 3 normal. We click on the rotate icon here several times until it moves in the direction we need. Then we click on the work area button, which sets the work area to the duration of the behavior so that we know that when it should start at the beginning of the composition, it will end here. We move the current time indicator to this endpoint and make sure timing is set to end of behavior, since this position should be the end and not the start of the animation. Then we make sure the layer is selected and apply the behavior. We don't want to split the layer into individual characters this time, since it should animate and deform as one single block. In general, I recommend you experiment with both alternatives and see which looks better. Now we rotate the behavior again as needed and apply it to the second text. Let's also choose a sound effect this time. Let's use the friction high. When we apply the behavior, now also some additional layers for the sound effects have been created. Finally, let's animate the rectangle, this time using the rotate scale in one fast behavior. This animation should end about here where the text reached its final location. So with the timing end of behavior, we apply it to the shape layer. Now everything animates in nicely, so next we add an animation at the end to let everything disappear again. For the text, we choose the mat move disappear thrown 3 normal, rotate as needed, and go to the time where the out animation should start. This time we go to the start of the animation because the current position of the text should be at the start point and not at the end point of this animation. Therefore, we also ensure that the timing option is set to start of behavior. We apply it to the first text, rotate as needed, and apply it to the second text, this time again with an abstract sound effect. Finally, we apply the rotate scale out one fast behavior to the rectangle. And this is the result. Now if we go back to Premiere Pro, you will notice the sound effects are missing. This is because Premiere has only replaced the video clip by the After Effects composition, but not the audio clip. To fix this, we right-click on the video clip and choose Reveal in Project to see the corresponding item in the project panel. Now we can simply drag it into the sequence a second time, and this time it comes in with both video and audio. That's it for today. In the next part of this tutorial series, we are going to take a look at another lower third with a different style. If you can't wait to see the next part, please also subscribe to our newsletter at mamaworld.com/subscribe. Since in the newsletter we share our tutorials already before they are released on the website. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk for mamaworld.com, and we'll see you next time.